blizzard warnings continue across all of our viewing area as we head to the afternoon and evening hours today. A quick update on the snow that's continuing to fall. Moderate to heavy snowfall for the bulk of our viewing area at noon right now. Take a look at Storm View Doppler radar, and you can see all of the dark blue shadings towards mainly the south and the east, but now pushing its way into a good portion of the 435 loop, indicating moderate to heavy snowfall. Visibility for some very close to zero, and conditions certainly hazardous to be out there for the time being. Blizzard warning will continue from now through tomorrow morning. We've got at least a 12-hour window for most that we will continue to see moderate to heavy snowfall across the area. We are still anticipating at least a foot of snowfall within the 435 loop. Heavier amounts the farther south and east that you live, south of I-70 and on the Missouri side. And if you are heading out, we want to make sure that you know, be prepared in case something does happen and you do get stranded. We have wind chills that we are expecting for the next several hours and into tonight in the ballpark of 10 to 20 degrees below zero. We also want to keep you up to date on the road conditions. Chris Kess is keeping an eye on that. Chris.
Erin Little, thanks. Here it is midday, and the drive on this Tuesday, an adventure to say the least. All right, let's get you caught up on where things stand. First, KDOT, Kim Qualls at the office there in Topeka on the phone with us right now as we look at some scout cameras so far. Kim, with 12 more hours of moderate to heavy snowfall due in Kansas City right now, I assume your crews are out in it right now. What are you hearing?
Yes, they are, and they are fighting the challenge of trying to get down to pavement. We're probably not going to see that anytime soon. We've got lots of snow falling, and it's blowing, which creates even kind of more difficulties for the crews in trying to get that snow off the road and keep it off.
Is that the assessment essentially on the Kansas side of the metropolitan area, or does that also apply to what's happening up in northeast Kansas as well?
No, that holds true in northeast Kansas as well. We have a little bit less snow falling over here, so we do see a little more pavement on some of our roadways. But throughout all of northeast Kansas, we do have the snow-packed conditions and the blowing and drifting snow both. In fact, we're now seeing some east-west roads that have conditions of drifting occurring on them as well.
How bad a storm is this, or is it too soon to say?
Too soon to say, I think. You know, maybe ask me in about another 5 hours and I can give you a better feel. But it's definitely, for the metro area, this is one of the biggest ones that we have seen in a while.
And travel not advised from the perspective of KDOT?
Yes, most definitely. KDOT encourages everyone to stay home, the rest of the day, tonight, and then, you know, let's all stop and look and see what it looks like in the morning. But at this point, we strongly discourage any travel this evening, this afternoon, and overnight.
Kim Qualls, who has been good enough to join us from early this morning on First News. Here we are midday, and we may be knocking on your door 5 hours from now. Kim Qualls, thanks.
Thank you.
All right, let's get the latest on the Missouri side right now. Bill Billings from MoDOT on the phone with us right now. Bill, I assume you heard Kim Qualls there, your colleague from KDOT. Much the same report from you?
Much the same, yes. We would definitely encourage people to stay home and not put themselves at risk by getting out in this. It's a major snowstorm that's causing a lot of problems out on the road. We have pretty well snow-packed roads. Some of it's so deep that it's just, you know, very, very hard to get across it. So we are in a gang plowing mode, which means that we have trucks that are going together and trying to keep our major routes open. I just got off of I-70, and it's the same way, you know. So just I would just encourage people to stay home and, you know, ride this thing out. Just don't get out in it.
Are your crews at this point finding a losing battle through no fault of your own?
Well, it's a challenge. It's a challenge. I mean, of course, we're up to it. And of course, we're doing the very, very best we can. It is challenging with the wind that keeps blowing the snow back over the top of it. We'll get clear, but you know, just minutes after we go through there, it's covered over again. So that is a challenging aspect, but we'll stay at it as long as we need to.
And I don't know how many years, Bill, you've been at this, but worst storm you've seen?
Yes, I have to say it's probably the worst one I've seen. I've been with MoDOT for about 23 years. And I don't recall anything quite this bad. But, you know, memory kind of fades every once in a while. We had some bad storms in 93. We had some bad ones in the early 80s. And, you know, I mean, so, you know, this is Missouri. Yeah, we have to expect one of these every once in a while.
Bill Billings with MoDOT, and want to thank you for all of your help throughout the day and for your help later on in the day. Appreciate it, Bill.
You bet. Not a problem.
All right. City halls throughout the metropolitan area are closing early today because of the storm. If you have to venture out today and that trip involves a city hall, you may want to call ahead just to make sure that they are, in fact, open. Of course, hourly updates continue throughout the day here on KMBC Channel 9. A full report later on this afternoon. KMBC 9 News launching early today at 4 o'clock this afternoon. And, of course, updates anytime at KMBC.com.
Stay connected to weather coverage you can count on at KMBC.com.